What is the shape of RBC in vitamin B12? It will be increased. Very good. Megaloblastic anemia. Megaloblastic anemia will be seen in vitamin B12, right? I already discussed it here. Vitamin B12 and folic acid deficiency leads to megaloblastic anemia. Okay, very good.
Cell shape.
There is a spherocytes can be seen, but not all spherocytes is vitamin B12 deficiency. There is a hereditary spherocytosis also. Okay. Spherocytes might be seen, but presence of spherocytes doesn't mean a megaloblastic anemia. It can be a hereditary spherocytosis also. We need to do genetic testing. Yes. Size and shape both. No, size and shape are different. Size will be the overall size of the RBC, whereas the shape will be biconcave to spherical. Okay? Biconcave to spherical will be the shape. So, in vitamin B12 deficiency, we will see a megaloblastic anemia where the size and shape of RBC will be altered. They will be large. The size will be big. And there is a tendency of spherocytosis, but not true spherocytosis, not the hereditary spherocytosis. That's what I was trying to say. Yes.
Vitamin B12 deficiency,
pernicious anemia. In vitamin B12, there is a chance of pernicious anemia. In pernicious anemia, I will tell, the cell size will be large. Parallelly, within the red blood cell, you will see granules or small granules. Okay, there will be small granules. This is pernicious anemia. Vitamin B12 deficiency also causes pernicious anemia, where the cell will be increased and there will be granules within the RBC. Okay, yes. And megaloblastic anemia is seen in folic acid deficiency. So yeah, purely vitamin B12 pernicious, folic, megaloblastic together. Megaloblastic is common symptom. Okay, common marker presentation. Common presentation. Alright students, I will continue revision. Meanwhile, let me finish cancers. Okay, lymphoproliferative cancers. Please shift to cancers now. I will discuss cancers, then I will come back to the revision. Okay, listen everyone. Pay attention to the leukemias now. Lymphoproliferative leukemias. I will tell very interesting stories now. Listen. Let me keep this here. Yes. Pay attention. Class, everyone take your leukemia notes, okay? It's okay. Nothing happened, don't worry. Alright. Class, pay attention, everyone. Yes. Class. Class. Enough. So far in the leukemias, we discussed about myeloproliferative leukemias. Am I correct? We finished all myeloproliferative leukemias. There are AML and CML. Acute myeloleukemias and chronic myeloleukemias. Right? This is all about myeloleukemias. Now I will focus on lymphoid leukemias. Okay? Some of the examples of class. Krishnakant, Sakil, Saurabh, Sakshi, Tanisha, Keith, yes, lymphoid leukemias, right? What are the diseases we see in myeloid leukemias? Polycythemia vera, in case of erythrocytes. What are the other conditions? Tell me.
Chronic myelogenous leukemia. Essential thrombocytopenia.
Thrombocyte issues, because thrombocytes are also released from megakaryocyte, a monocyte. Okay, monocyte will give megakaryocyte. Megakaryocyte will give platelets. Leukemia is a type of myeloid leukemia because platelets derive from monocyte. That is megakaryocyte, a subset of monocyte. Okay, good. Now, I will focus on lymphoid leukemias. Pay attention. Lymphoid leukemias. Pay attention, class. Lymphoid has two important things. Remember, lymphoma and lymphoid leukemia. These two terms are very important. In order to understand what is lymphoma and leukemia, pay attention. See, these are our B cells. B cells will produce antibodies. Am I correct? So what B cells will do is, parallelly within the body there are blood vessels, and there are different type of blood vessels. Okay, those blood vessels are called as lymphatic vessels. Lymphatic vessels. So what is the role of these lymphatic vessels? Lymphatic vessels have pores like this. Okay, they have pores. Listen, the purpose of lymphatic vessels is, during a normal blood circulation, during normal blood pressure, some of the blood will be filtered. There is a regular filtration of blood and tissues. During this filtration, some of the fluid will be trapped in the extracellular spaces. During blood pressure, some tissue fluid might trap under my skin. Okay, that will cause swelling. I need to remove this swelling fluid. Okay? The trapped fluid is called as lymph. Trapped, filtered blood fluid is called as lymph. Lymph will be outside the blood vessels, in intercellular spaces, in between the cells or tissues, we will see this lymph. Lymph will be a very problematic thing. Why it is problematic? Because this lymph is not in circulation. So bacteria will start, imagine a stagnated water and a flowing water. Flowing water will be pure, stagnated water will have all parasites, everything. It will be dirty and it will have, you will get diseases with stagnated water. Similarly, a stagnated fluid is not good. The stagnated fluid is lymph. I need to drive this fluid outside from the tissues. How I can drive this? For that purpose, I have a separate drying system, a drainage system. And the drainage vessels are lymphatic vessels. Unlike blood vessels, lymphatic vessels have holes, okay, unidirectional walls are there. Okay, what happens with this lymphatic vessel is, this excessive fluid will enter into the lymphatic vessel, excess fluid will enter into the lymphatic vessel. Now, since this is a trapped fluid, the chances of bacteria in this fluid is high. The chances of infectious material in this fluid is high. And directly diverting this fluid back to the circulation is not good. If I circulate this fluid directly into the systemic circulation, that can cause some systemic infections. I need to filter this fluid now. I need to do some filtering, like a groundwater filtering, right? Like our aqua purifier. I need to purify this lymph. To purify this lymph, first I penetrate the lymph via lymphatic vessels. Now, these lymphatic vessels, before circulating back to the systemic circulation, there is a purifier. Okay, that purifier is called as node. That purifier is called as a node. That node is called as lymph node. Is it clear? Drainage water, before dumping into drinking water, we are purifying it in an aqua purifier. That purifier is our lymph node. Okay? Now, lymph node. In lymph node, what is there means, lymph node has lymphocytes. Here we have B lymphocytes and T lymphocytes. What they will do is, they will destroy any pathogens. If there are any pathogens, those pathogens will be destroyed by lymph nodes. the B cells and T cells in the lymph node will destroy the pathogens. After destroying the pathogen, okay, if there are pathogens, then this fluid will be redirected to the systemic circulation. Is it clear? That is the purpose of lymph nodes. Okay, now I will give one example. Our body has kept many lymph nodes in the sites of risks. One of the risky sites is even mouth. Okay, you are eating all dirty things in the body, right? All food is already contaminated in one way or other way. Exposed to the environment, all food has some contamination. Am I correct? That contaminants will be destroyed in the stomach, in the acidity, but not in the mouth. Got my point? A contaminated food will be destroyed in the stomach, but not in the mouth. There is a chance of spreading of bacteria from the food via mouth. From mouth, they can enter into the nasal cavity to the brain or something they can do. Am I correct? So what we did is, in the mouth, we have a rich amount of lymphatic vessels, and these lymphatic vessels made a lymph nodes. Okay, lymph nodes at the pharyngeal part. Okay, when you open your mouth, you will see a umbilical, right? Near tonsils. What are tonsils? Swollen lymph nodes. Swollen lymph nodes in the oropharynx. Swollen lymph nodes in the oropharynx, inside the mouth. Okay, they are lymph nodes actually. Lymph nodes were swollen. Why they are swollen? Because some bacteria entered into the mouth and lymph nodes captured the bacteria, and there are many B cells in the lymph nodes. Okay, they are trying to destroy the bacteria, leading to a swollen lymph node. That is tonsils. See, now we understood what the purpose of tonsils. Okay, yeah. Clear, right? Coming back to this lecture. Similarly, we have a concentrated lymph nodes here in the neck, concentrated lymph nodes in the axillary part, and in case of women, concentrated lymph nodes in the breast. The reason is the baby will drink milk, and baby is always exposed to environment. So there is a chance of getting bacteria into the mammary glands, into the breast, via baby mouth. There is a high chance of getting infection via baby mouth. So we must keep a rich amount of lymph nodes in the mammary glands. This will cause another risk. The risk I will tell you. When there is any B cell cancer, that is our lymphocyte cancer, lymphoproliferative leukemias, these B cells, first they will reside in the lymph nodes. The cancer will start with lymph nodes, because lymph nodes are the reservoir of B cells. You got my point? Lymph nodes are the reservoir of B cells. Now, the first swelling in case of cancer, a lymphoproliferative cancer, will be initiated from the lymphatic vessels and lymph nodes. Now they will migrate to the antibody. Okay. So a lymph node inflammation.
Hello sir. See, automatically they will understand when I take class.
Yeah. Yes. Swelling of lymph node is called as lymphoma. Swelling of lymph node is called as lymphoma. Swelling of lymph node is called as lymphoma. Okay? Not all lymphomas are cancers. Is it clear? Not all lymphomas are cancers. Maybe there is a tonsillitis or other, heavy infection. A heavy infection can give lymphoma. Got it? And lympholeukemia. Directly the B cells have some proper cancer activity through bone marrow. Through bone marrow there is an activity. Now listen. Some of the viruses, when we get a virus infection, this virus will migrate to the nearby lymph node and they will destroy the stem or the B cells in the lymph nodes, and they will re-engineer the B cells. The pre-engineered B cells might become an aggressive cancer cells. That is an epigenetic factor. A virus introduced a cancer in the body. Okay. So, yes, these things we will see. And I will tell you a very interesting story about the recent taxes. See the board now. I'm just giving all these things. Yeah. See, this story, I like it a lot. I know this story since 5 years actually. So she is a news anchor. Okay. One day she is taking her news. Okay. She is doing her interview on a television. What happened? Listen, there is a viewer. There is a doctor who is randomly watching TV in his clinic, and he suspected something in her. When she is okay, first she saw she is beautiful, but she observed something near her neck. Okay? She observed something near her neck, and he tried to approach her. He called her to the news media, and then he tried to approach the news media to approach the anchor. And you know what happened? Very luckily, it turns out to be a cancer. She was diagnosed as a cancer. It's a leukemia. And that is a blessings, okay? Blessings from a viewer. A viewer randomly saw that there is a problem with this woman. And she kept this in the picture also. That, you know? Yeah. You know how the doctor diagnosed? Because doctor always seeing lymphoid leukemias, okay? So doctor suspected a swelling, and that is not a normal swelling. A small swelling in the neck lead to a cancer. She came out as a cancer survivor actually. She got a deadliest cancer and she survived because the cancer has been identified in the early stage by a doctor. If not, she might see this after 1 or 2 years. By that time, her cancer will be very heavy.
Sir, so, can I repeat the last respect?
So there is another cancer survivor. The cancer survivor also approached her. Okay, this, no, yeah. So yes.
The doctor's message. Hmm? Doctor's message.
Doctor's
message.
Yeah, yeah.
So I saw your report. What cancer is lump in your neck? See, the doctor's report. So actually, doctor's. Yeah. So there is one more cancer survivor. That's why this doctor, you know, that is for expertise.
Okay. So my conclusion is, a lymphoid leukemia will start with swellings as a lymphomas. Okay. Lymphomas means what are lymphomas? The swelling of lymph nodes. Maybe you think these things are normal. I just want to tell you the difference between Hodgkin lymphoma and non-Hodgkin's lymphoma. Okay? The difference between Hodgkin and non, this is very important. Hodgkin lymphoma will show swelling of lymph nodes. Swelling of lymph nodes will be seen in Hodgkin's lymphoma. Whereas a non-Hodgkin's lymphoma won't show any swellings. They will cause leukemia or cancers. Okay? A Hodgkin's will show swelling, whereas non-Hodgkin's won't show swelling. Okay, now, next one. So, this is how the B cells will migrate to the lymph nodes, lymphatic vessels, lymph node swelling, lymphoma leads to a leukemia. So, yes, see, the differentiation between Hodgkin's and non-Hodgkin's lymphoma is differentiated by presence of Reed-Sternberg cells. Presence of Reed-Sternberg cells indicates a Hodgkin's lymphoma. This is the identification marker. Reed-Sternberg cells indicates a Hodgkin's lymphoma. Absence of Reed-Sternberg cells is a non-Hodgkin's lymphoma. Hodgkin's lymphoma can be detected by presence of Reed-Sternberg cells. There are many types of Reed-Sternberg cells, okay? Mummified cell, lamina cell, you know, pleomorphic, classical, monoclonal, lymphocytic. So these are various types of Reed-Sternberg cells. So these Reed-Sternberg cells will differentiate a Hodgkin's from non-Hodgkin's lymphoma, okay? I want to show you some pictures of Hodgkin's lymphoma, then you will understand the severity. Hodgkin's lymphoma is very common among African countries. I will show you a severe form of Hodgkin's lymphoma. So this is a Hodgkin's lymphoma. Okay, this is caused by a virus. This unfortunate patient got a viral infection, that is Epstein-Barr virus. This Epstein-Barr virus destroyed the genes of a stem cell, destroyed the genes of the B cells, leading to aggressive B cell activity, leading to a cancer. A virus caused a cancer. See, this is not a genetic. Rather than a virus caused a cancer, okay? This is one example. EBV lymphoma. Such lymphoma are called as Burkitt's lymphoma. Burkitt's lymphoma. Okay? So this is one classical example of Burkitt's lymphoma. Okay, this is detecting done here. See, it is again rotating that side. Okay. I will show another pictures of Burkitt's lymphoma. If you still think this is a normal thing, so this is endemic type of Burkitt's lymphoma. Very, very painful and infectious. First, the patient got a viral infection. Next, the patient went to a cancerous condition, to a leukemia condition. Very painful, very sad. I have seen more pictures of Burkitt's lymphoma. This is a severe form of oral Burkitt's lymphoma, where the lymphocytes within the oral cavity has been enlarged and they become cancerous. Yeah, so this is a mass tumor which is seen in this Burkitt's lymphoma condition. I think he can't even eat, how he is eating, I don't know. Very painful. Most of the Burkitt lymphomas are benign in nature, not malignant. That means you can remove these tumors. But still, we understood, once the cancer spreaded into lymph nodes, that is stage 3 and stage 4. Do you remember lymph nodes actually seen in stage 3 cancers? So, yeah, by this time these are aggressive cancers. Even after surgery, there is a chance of death. Burkitt's lymphoma are very painful and sad. Another one, Burkitt's lymphoma. Another severe form of Burkitt's lymphoma. See this. So now the tumor became so large that the skin started tearing because of the large tumor. Okay, the skin started stretching and it started giving secondary infections, abscess. Yeah, this is a Burkitt's lymphoma and a type of lymphoid leukemias. I think I have one more painful photo. By this, I will start this lecture. So, see, a mother came up with her Burkitt's son. So, this is very painful to see. Yeah.
A mother.
Then, coming to the non-Hodgkin's lymphoma, equally dangerous. At least in Hodgkin's lymphoma, we came to know there is a tumor, we identified, we can treat them. In non-Hodgkin's, the non-Hodgkin starts as a small mole, okay, a birthmark. A non-Hodgkin's lymphoma starts as a birthmark, but that is a cancerous mark. You know, in my childhood, my mother said, okay, she is also like Krishna, she was in hospital then. She said, I got a new birthmark, then she was, she was anxious and she immediately took me to the hospital, okay, because I got a multiple birthmarks here. See, you can see this. The multiple birthmarks came and she afraid that I got a cancer because she knows she is a practitioner, she is in the hospital, but turns out to be it's normal. But don't worry, yes, a birthmark can be a sign of cancers. That is my idea. Okay, see, non-Hodgkin's lymphoma will start as a small birthmark, okay, but don't be cautious, okay, don't be afraid. Not all birthmarks are cancers. Don't worry. That's why I don't want to discuss this. Actually, these birthmarks won't look like a normal birthmark. They have some characteristic phenomena, okay? They will be reddish spot with some lymphoid, swollen tissue surrounding the spot, okay? Can be seen like this. So, yeah, these are lymphoid. So, lymphoid leukemias are very common or simply the breast cancers or lymphoid leukemias. Now you understood, right? Most of the breast cancers are lymphoid leukemias. When you suspect any lump or any tumor inside the breast, please self-examine. It might be a leukemia. That can happen even epigenetically. Epigenetically means even to environmental factors, such as exposed to some viruses or even tobacco or passive tobacco or intake. Passive tobacco intake, what you know? The second person taking, you know, smoking and you will get that smoking and you will get a lymphoma. See? Yes. That's why recently, day before yesterday, we conducted cancer camp, right? So, when we say cancer camp and cancer test, no one will come. That's why we said we are giving, you know, we are doing normal blood tests. But parallelly, we are doing cancer markers also to catch any suspicious candidates in this population. Yeah, that's a good activity actually. Sometimes we need to lie for the, you know, societal benefits. Yeah. That's it. This is all about the lymphoid cancers. Right now, the classification of lymphoid cancers. Right now.
Surprise test,
sir. Surprise test also, don't worry. There will be a surprise test, get ready, okay? Yes, right of the classification, everyone. Classification, everyone. Types of lymphoproliferative disorders. Types of lymphoproliferative disorders or lymphoproliferative leukemias. Lymphoproliferative leukemias.
Classification.
Yes, classification. Types of lymphoproliferative leukemias. Types of lympholeukemias, simply. Types of lympholeukemias. There are two types. What are the two types? Chronic acute lympholeukemias and chronic lympholeukemias. Then types of chronic leukemias. Chronic lymphoid leukemias are two types, right now. Lymphoma. Now you understood what is lymphoma and leukemia, right? You already know. Lymphoma plus, other one is lymphoid leukemia. Lymphoid leukemia. Lymphoid leukemia. Okay? Now, lymphoma are further two types. There are two types of lymphomas. What are those? Hodgkin's. Yeah, Hodgkin's and non-Hodgkin's. How you can differentiate Hodgkin's from non-Hodgkin's? Hodgkin's.
Swollen of nerves.
Presence or absence of free Sternberg cells plus
swelling of nerves.
Okay, presence of free Sternberg cells and swellings. But keep in mind, listen. Swelling is not a single property to differentiate Hodgkin and non-Hodgkin. Okay? We need to consider each Sternberg cells also. Sternberg cells. Okay. Hodgkin's. Right now, types of Hodgkin's now. Types of Hodgkin's lymphoma. There are three types. B-cell neoplasm. B-cell neoplasm. That means B-cell cancer. Then second one, T-cell neoplasm. T-cell neoplasm. The third one, natural killer cell neoplasm. Now, right now the disease names of B-cell neoplasm, diseases of B-cell neoplasm, they are Burkitt's lymphoma, follicular lymphoma, mast cell lymphoma, and diffuse large B cell lymphoma. There is a huge classification of characterizing these diseases. You just know the basics. These basics is sufficient.
Okay. Sir, diffuse large B cell lymphoma.
All are cancers, keep in mind. And other T-cell lymphoma, here other T-cell lymphoma, another one, large aplastic T-cell lymphoma, large anaplastic, yes, T-cell lymphoma. These terms, anaplasia, dysplasia, metaplasia, these are the terms of tumor formation, do you remember?
Yeah. So, second one.
Large anaplastic T cell lymphoma. Then coming to the this one.
Natural
NK cell neoplasm. That's it. This is essentially these are the cells. That's it. Okay, natural.
This is the
then in a CLL also, in the leukemia, we have two types: Kairi cell leukemia and T cell polymorphic leukemia. Kairi cell leukemia and T cell polymorphic leukemia.
T cell polymorphic.
Okay. Kairi cell leukemia, I will tell. Is it possible to have a white blood cell, K to a white blood cell? Is it possible to have a K to a monocyte or a lymphocyte? Yeah, stem cell issues, okay? Tentomas, stem cell, again a cancer. Here we will see K to a cell. K, okay, it's ball to the cell. Yeah. Yes, T cell polymorphic leukemia.
Sir, first one is hair cell.
Yeah, K cell leukemia. The cells will have K, interestingly. Okay, teratomas actually.
Yes.
T cell polymorphic leukemia. T cell polymorphic leukemia. So this is instruments. This is all about the
CLL.
Okay. All these things will come in exam. And also you remember that what are the neutrophil abnormalities? The toxic granulations. Toxic granulocytic infections. What are those?
Inflammation.
All pregnant human disease, then everyone get ready for surprise test. Open your quiz form in the WhatsApp group. Get ready with your quiz form. There will be a surprise test.